here with you today?
I'm with my dad.
Thank you for taking me, like, honestly.
It'll be great.
I can't imagine doing this without you here. I love you, Dad. I love you so much.
Hello.
Hi, how are you?
And what's your name?
Mandy Harvey.
And who's this?
My interpreter.
What's your name?
Sarah.
Nice to meet you, Sarah.
Nice to meet you, Sarah.
Hi, Sarah.
Doing well, thank you. Hello.
Okay, Mandy, so I think I've worked this out. So you're deaf?
Yes, I lost all my hearing when I was 18 years old.
Wow, and how old are you now?
29, so it's 10 years.
Wow. And Mandy, how did you lose your hearing, if you don't mind me asking?
I have a connective tissue disorder, so basically I got sick and my nerves deteriorated.
Growing up, the only thing I wanted to do was sing. I ended up going to school for vocal music education so that I could have that be my life. When I was in college, I thought I had an ear infection, and it just got worse and worse. And by Christmas, I was borderline legally deaf in both ears. There was one day where the teacher was going to play the piano, and I had to chart out everything that he was playing. And I had my pencil ready, and everybody else's pencils start moving, and I'm just waiting for the test to start. And then one by one, every person just got up and left the room. And I didn't hear enough to even start the test. That was the last day I was a part of music program. That was a bad day.
When we're sitting in the car together to come home, she said, "Dad, I can't remember what your voice sounds like anymore." At that moment, you knew that things would never be the same.
Everything that I had ever wanted was just going away, and I couldn't stop it.
The music is alive inside of her. The only question was, what could she do with it now?
My dad, he suggested that we play a song. I said, well, that's crazy. But I had a guitar tuner, and I hummed my starting note and just went for it. Music now isn't about the sound, it's about the feeling.
I'm excited, I'm nervous, I'm scared, so I'm just trying to.
It's not the dream that I always had. That's okay, because I showed up and I did something I never believed I could do.
So, you were singing before you lost your hearing?
Yeah, I've been singing since I was 4. So I left music after I lost my hearing and then figured out how to get back into singing with muscle memory, using visual tuners and trusting my pitch.
So your shoes are off because you're feeling the vibration. Is that how you're following the music?
Yeah, I'm feeling the tempo, the beat through the floor.
And Mandy, what are you gonna sing?
I'm gonna sing a song that I wrote called Try.
Okay, can you tell me what it's about?
After I lost my hearing, I gave up, but I want to do more with my life than just give up. So.
Good for you. Good for you. Okay, well, look, this is your moment and good luck.
Okay.
Blue. But I know one day I'll get through.
Mandy, I don't think you're going to need a translator for this. Honestly, I never think I'm going to be surprised or amazed by people, and then you turn up. And with, I mean, just the fact that you are you, but it was your voice, your tone, the song was beautiful. Congratulations, you are straight through to the live shows. Mandy, you know what? We found each other.
Yes. And you can tell everything I do. This is a song. And maybe quite simple. But then it's gone. I hope you don't mind. I hope you don't mind that I put down the words.
What just happened?
Life is now you're in the world.
Penn State's sled hockey team opened the defense of its gold medal at the Paralympic Winter Games in Pyeongchang, South Korea, by defeating Japan 10-0 in a preliminary game. A week from now, Team USA hopes to be celebrating its third consecutive Paralympic gold. For our Sunday closer, Harry Smith caught up with the guys as they prepared for the games.
Recently at the Harbor Center in Buffalo, New York, the USA sled hockey team was being put through their paces. Sled hockey is a sport of skill, strength, and guts. Players propel themselves down the ice with picks at the end of their sticks. And check out the goalie's gear.
Show me what you got here.
This is a stick that I pretty much craft myself. I hand make these. Allows me to dig to the back.
This thing looks dangerous.
You don't want to get in front of me, that's for sure.
Ancient warriors would be envious. The team is made up of men who have lost limbs or mobility due to disease, accidents, and war. Friends describe Ralph de Quebec, the team's newest player, as a Marine's Marine. An IED took both his legs.
When you come home and you're trying to get better, what's that like?
When you wake up in the hospital bed, you think to yourself, what's next? I don't know what I'm gonna do with the rest of my life. I want to still be a Marine, and you're trying to figure that all out at that instant.
Someone at Walter Reed suggested sled hockey. It was love at first hit.
My very first hit in sled hockey, I literally try to put a guy through the boards. And I'm like, where's the whistle? And there's no whistle. And I'm like, this is a sport for me.
Show them they have no hope going into Korea, all right? Work on three. 1, 2, 3, work!
What does it mean to you to be playing in the Paralympics?
Feels good. A lot of sacrifice. But to be able to do it, it means a lot.
That night, the U.S. team played an exhibition against the Canadians. It was brutal. A friendly rivalry, this is not. Goalkeeper Steve Cash has helped the USA to 2 gold medals in Vancouver in 2010 and in Sochi in 2014. He lost a leg to cancer when he was not yet in grade school.
You grew up in a household with brothers, right?
Yes, three older brothers. They never let me feel sorry for myself. It helped me kind of mold my vision of being able-bodied for the rest of my life.
Each player has fought his way onto the ice for reasons perhaps only a disabled person can understand.
You're all in an even playing field, and I think that's the beauty of the sport, because in the disabled community, you have your times, your moments of darkness.
Which means the sled hockey team is not just playing for themselves or even for their country, because sometimes in the crowd, there's a kid like 9-year-old Braden Montheny, who lost his legs to meningitis when he was a baby.
Let's see what you got.
It's signed by all the players.
Signed by all the players.
It's very cool.
Braden already seems to know no boundaries, but seeing there are other people who are kind of like you, who go out do this, well, it gets your attention. For Sunday Today, Harry Smith, Buffalo.
And boy, are they good. Harry, thank you very much. You can watch the U.S. Paralympic sled hockey team in its pursuit of yet another gold medal tonight and all week on NBCSN.
They've got some great chemistry. We saw some of that last night, and here goes Brody.
Brody Roybal, 4 points in the opening game. Weaving in, shoots and scores. Just a little over a minute into the first, the United States strikes first. There for the Czechs. Safranek trying to push it around. It deflects in front. Open net, and that's easy pickings for Declan Farmer. And the United States thwarted on its earlier power play attempt. Not this time. Farmer snaps one home. 3-0, Team USA. Wallace calling for it. Lost the handle, tracking back his page to keep it alive. His shot deflected in front. Secondary chance, flipped home by Farmer. U.S. 3 in the first, 1 already here in the second. You're in the midway point of this 15-minute period. Stick handling from Farmer to Wallace. Tees it up, shoots and scores. A beauty for the Paralympic rookie. Look at the work from Roybal to get space, some separation. Trying to centering, pass. Got it back, wraparound opportunity, shot and a score. Brody Roybal flashing in front and adding to the U.S. lead.
The key is to keep propelling yourself with whichever hand you don't have the puck on so that you don't ever stop.
Weird hop back out in front. Dotson slots one home.
The job that U.S. has done developing players over the years at such a young age to get them up to this level is unbelievable.
Wow, Farmer in front, able to flick that home. Nice feed from Landeros, and the U.S. does not need a lot of time on the power play to cash in. Great look at the stick work from Farmer. Mishevich from behind, Roybal, and that is too easy right now for Team USA. Breakdown of the back, and the Czechs getting punished.
Just haven't been able to develop their program to the point that it needs to be to really compete in this April for a medal.
Dotson racing in. He'll score his second of the game. And the U.S. quest for a third straight Paralympic gold. We know it's going to continue into the last 4 in the competition as the U.S. has another solid victory. 10-0 the final over the Czech Republic.
for USA sled hockey team. Fox says Brody Logan is here with the story. What a story it is too, Brody.
It's an amazing story, and what I love about this kid, I call him a kid, he's 18, is that he cares more about what he does on the ice than what he's been through in his life and his great accomplishments there. So it was the most dramatic moment in sports of the week, probably the most dramatic moment you don't know about. Down 1-0 with 35 seconds left in the gold medal game against Canada, USA sled hockey team tied with less than a minute left. Then in sudden overtime, they won the game in dramatic fashion to take home the gold medal. A local member of that team, 18-year-old Noah Grove, is set to receive a hero's welcome next week when his hometown of Frederick, Maryland, celebrates Noah Grove Day in his honor. The 18-year-old won gold in his first Paralympics in South Korea, but he almost didn't even make it to elementary school. He was diagnosed with bone cancer when he was 4 years old. Noah had his leg amputated above his knee at 5. The surgery was needed to save his life. But that's nothing for Noah. He's a hockey player through and through. To Noah, his crowning achievement doesn't take place in a hospital. It takes place on the hockey ice.
Other than winning the gold medal, I'd say the fondest memory was probably scoring my first goal against Japan. Absolute rocket, top corner from hash marks. So it was great to get the tournament started off like that. I think the path I'm on right now, I think it'd be appropriate to end up going to like med school or something, but I have a passion for that. I want to become an orthopedic oncologist, kind of help kids who are just like me, and but I'm not sure where, you know, my journey's going at this point.
So no one wants to pay it forward. After so many doctors at Georgetown MedStar helped him, he wants to help others after medical school. And his other goal is to get inducted into the Maryland Sports Hall of Fame, following in the tradition of his grandfather, Phil Grove, a horse racing jockey inducted in 1994. It's in the genes.